Hey, beautiful souls. Now, I know a lot of people tend to think that getting stiffer, losing range of motion is a natural part of aging, but it's actually not at all. What tends to happen is because we slow down and we do less activity and we move less, so our body starts to seize up. But it doesn't have to be that way. We don't have to lose range of mobility. As long as we keep our body moving, we can stay fit and mobile. And also working on our mobility and flexibility helps to reduce stress and can also boost our mood as well. It can help us feel healthier and happier. So I'm just going to share a very simple little chair-based mobility routine. So if you've got a chair, make sure that you've got space behind you so you're not going to wall behind you. And make sure your feet are flat on the floor. And you're sitting up nice and tall. And just take a quick moment just to notice how you feel right now, so you can notice how you feel at the end. And notice any tension anywhere, notice any aches or pains, because, you know, we don't feel great every day. We have days where we feel a bit stiff and tight, and we have days where we feel really good. So just noticing, without criticism, without judgment, how you feel right now, and so we can compare it how good we feel at the end. Remember, it's never too late to work on your mobility and flexibility either. You know, it's never too late to start. It's never too late to improve your mobility. I mean, I'm 46 years old now. I'm closer to 50 than I am to 40. And I've still got pretty much full range of movement, but I work on it every day. Then just gently draw your belly button in. And sitting up nice and tall. Make sure your spine is nice and tall so we're not slouched. Visualize extending your tailbone down towards the floor. And imagine you've got a hook attach the crown of your head, and that's stretching up towards the ceiling. And that naturally helps your posture as well. If you're worried about, like, if you want to lose weight, I'll give you one easy tip that makes you look like you've instantly lost weight. Posture, okay? When you sit up nice and tall, you naturally look slimmer, taller, and healthier as well. And our organs aren't getting compressed. So always sitting up nice and tall, gently draw your belly button in, just relax your arms down. We're just gonna inhale, stretch the arms up. Exhale, lower them down. Now don't worry if you can't get your arms all the way up to touch, just bring them up as high as you can. So we're also working on mobility in our shoulders. And inhale, stretch up, feel the length in the spine. Exhale as you lower your arms down. And try and keep your shoulders relaxed as you do that, so you're not shrugging your shoulders around your ears. It also starts to lengthen your spine as well as we do that. Just a couple more. Inhale, reach up as tall as you can. And exhale as you lower the arms down. Just once more. Breathe in. And breathe out. And inhale, reach one arm up. Exhale, stretch across, stretching out those intercostal muscles. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, lower down, other side. And it also helps us to breathe when we stretch out our intercostal muscles, the muscles around the rib cage. We can breathe more easily. The rib cage can expand more easily. And it's also good for a strong, healthy back to move our spine in all directions every day. And you might find you can stretch a little bit further each time you do it. So that once more each side. Even just doing these exercises like first thing in the morning or the middle of the day when you need a bit of an energy boost. And it will give you more energy as well, because we often have tension, we keep tension trapped in our body. And just extend the arms out in front of you, shoulders relax. Inhale, flex the hands up and try not to let the fingers curl. Try and extend the fingers up. And exhale, flex them down. As you're doing that, keep the shoulders relaxed. People tend to experience things like arthritis in our hands and fingers. So if you want to keep your hands and fingers free from arthritis, then you need to exercise them. And you also feel a stretch in your arms as well. And then just circle those wrists, still sitting up nice and tall, tummy drawn in, shoulders relaxed, circle the wrists around. Then round the other way, just breathe in. Breathe out. And imagine you've got something on the tip of your thumb and you're trying to flick it off. And do that as fast as you can. Just breathe as you're doing that. So we're exercising the muscles, tendons, ligaments in our hands and fingers. And you'll feel it. You'll feel your muscles in your hands working, because we're not used to exercising our hands, and it will keep your hands and fingers healthy so you won't get all gnarly hands from arthritis. And release, and just shuffle forward a little bit. Then we're going to inhale, open the arms out, open your chest. As you breathe out, try and hug one knee in towards your chest. Now you might not get it all the way in, and that's absolutely fine. Inhale, open. Exhale, hug the other knee and really hug it in. So opening up our chest, then warming up into our hips. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. You might find you can hug a little bit further each time. And we get a lot of tightness around our hips. This time you're going to hold it here, relax your shoulders, sit up nice and tall, and just circle that foot. We all need to exercise our feet as well. You might hear a bit of popping and cracking. Put the Rice Krispies, get rid of that, and round the other way. Still draw your belly button in so you're engaging your tummy muscles. And just point and flex that foot. And release it. Inhale, open the arms. Exhale, hug the other knee in. Sit up nice and tall as you can, tummy in. And circle the upper. So just make sure you're not slouching against the back of the chair. Sitting up nice and tall, that will help engage your core muscles as well. Change direction. Again, point and flex your foot a couple of times. And release. And just shuffle over to one side, so you've got one butt cheek off the chair. Then stretch that other leg out behind you, toe tucked under, so you're in a lunge position. Now straight away you'll feel that nice stretch in your hip flexors. That's really good. Try and sit up nice and tall so you're not tipping forward. So stretching the front of the body. Try and firm up this back leg as well. You can hold onto the chair if you need to. Inhale up, exhale, stretch. Oh, I feel that stretch. Inhale as you come up. Just open the arm out to the side, shoulders relaxed. Exhale, up and over, feel that stretch. Inhale, come back up, keep the back leg strong. So press through your heel on that back foot. Oh, once more, exhale, up and across. And inhale, back up. Then bring that back leg, swing it forward. Flex that foot and hinge forward, stretching out your hamstrings. Now you might not be able to come as fast forward as me, that's absolutely fine. You might be able to reach your toes. You might be able to hold onto your toes and really stretch out the hamstrings. Now these might be very tight, often very tight to start with, so make sure you breathe. Don't hold your breath, otherwise the muscles will tense up. And if you can't reach your toes, if you're up here, that's fine, just hinge forward, flexing that front foot. Taking nice deep breaths. And come back up. Then you're going to take that knee out to the side. The knee's at a right angle. We're going to come into a warrior two position. So you're going to stretch another leg out. This knee bent. Turn your chest towards me and stretch the arms out into a warrior two position. And we're going to inhale, bring your elbow to your thigh, reach that arm over, take a breath here, and as you breathe out, come up and over, bring your back hand to your back thigh, stretch up, either look up or look down to your back foot, whatever feels best for your neck. Inhale up, exhale, up and over, so you can turn your eye gaze upwards for that lovely stretch. As you come up, you're activating your core muscles as well. Inhale up, exhale across. Breathe in, breathe out. Oh, that feels so good. We've got one more. Also helps to strengthen your legs, tone up your tummy muscles. Oh, breathe out. Come back to warrior two, relax those arms, bring your legs in and take your knees out nice and wide. Press your knees out, so don't let the knees drop in, so you're engaging your inner thighs. and just gently grip with your feet. So you're lifting the arches of your feet, squeeze your butt slightly. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, hinge forward. As you come forward, don't let the knees drop in. Inhale, stretch up. And exhale, hinge forward. Warming into those hips. Inhale, stretch up. Exhale, forward. Keep that belly firm. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Lift up. Then from here, interlink your hands. Turn them inside out. Keep those knees pressed out. Stretch the arms up. Relax your shoulders. And inhale, a little side stretch. Keep pressing the knees out. Exhale, brace as you lift up. Inhale, over the other side. And exhale, brace as you lift up. Release those arms. Now walk those knees back in. You'll feel the stretch in the hips and inner thighs. And we do all on the other side. So just shuffle yourself over. So you've got one butt cheek hanging off. Stretch that other leg behind you into a lunge position. So I quite handily got the wall here, so I can press my heel against the wall. But try you're on the ball of the back foot. And inhale, lift up. Exhale, stretch. Feel the stretch in the hip flexors. Inhale, come up. Just take the arm out to the side. Exhale, lift up and over. Feel that gorgeous stretch. Inhale, up. Twice more. Exhale, across. Inhale, lift. One more. Now lift up, then bring that back leg, swing it forward, flex those toes, and hinge forward. And you might not come all the way forward, or you might find you can grab hold of your toes and feel that stretch in your hamstrings. You can also stretch out the muscles in your spine as well. So just breathe here. Make sure you're on a chair that doesn't slip. Nice deep breaths. And when we hold the breath, we hold the tension in our body. So breathe easy, breathe deep again. Don't worry if you're up here somewhere and you're nowhere near your toes, you'll still get a stretch in your hamstrings, I promise you. Then come up. Take that knee out to the side at a right angle position. Stretch your other leg out in front. So you're in a warrior two position. Arms out. Bring your elbow, but just make sure you're not hanging out here, okay? So you want to engage our core muscles. Other arm by your ear, so you're feeling a stretch along the side body. Breathe in. Then breathe out. Come up and over. Stretch. Again, either look up or look down to that back foot. Inhale. Across, elbow to thigh, chest open. Exhale, up and over. Drawing your belly button in to engage your core. Over and exhale, up and back. One more. Inhale and exhale. Inhale back to warrior two. Relax those arms, bring those legs in. Again, just take those knees out, press those knees out, lifting up nice and tall. Imagine you're trying to bring your big toes in towards your inside heel, so you're not just letting your knees drop in. Inhale, stretch up. Exhale, hinge forward. Inhale, rise up, firm up the belly, keep the knees out. Exhale, forward. Great stretch for your hips. In and out. Inhale, come up. Reach your right arm up. Drop your hand down between the shoulders. If you can, grab hold of your elbow, press that down. Make sure your knees haven't just collapsed in. So we're engaging our inner thighs as well. Inhale, lift the elbow up. Exhale, stretch across. Just take a breath here. Keep pressing those knees out. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, release the arms. Other side, stretch up. Drop the hand down. If you can't hold onto the elbow, just push. Inhale, lift the elbow up. Exhale, stretch. It's great for the shoulders. Try and relax around your shoulder joints. Inhale, up. Exhale, release the arms. Now walk those feet in.
going to stretch in the hips and inner thighs. Just bring your knees together, take your hand to the outside of one knee, turn through your ribs, you can hold onto the back of your chair, great stretch for your spine. Just take a breath here. Unwind and go the other way. So press your hand against your knee, your knees against your hand, turn through your ribs, turn through your chest, and hold onto the back of the chair. It's great for releasing tension in the spine. Twists are so good for you. And gently unwind, come back, and just notice how you feel now. You should feel looser, freer, and also have a little bit more energy, because when we get tight and tense, our energy can't flow through our body, and we just feel just crap when we're tight and tense, don't we? And if you want to stay mobile and active literally for the whole of your life, then you just need to keep moving. As I said earlier, it's never too late to work on your mobility. And if you'd like to know a little bit more about what I do, just holler at me, just send me a message. Always here for feedback, questions, requests. So if there's something particular you want to work on as well, please just send me a message. Enjoy the rest of your day, beautiful souls.